No podía creer, doctor. Muchísimas gracias al señor Julián Escutia y al señor Carlos Jiménez Macías. Estoy pues, muy contenta, muy orgullosa. También mi sincero agradecimiento al señor Pasañas, Miguel Pasañas, que es el embajador de México en los Estados Unidos. Muchísimas gracias a todos. Well, and to my colleagues, the members of the NAVE board, thank you very, very much for your nomination for this award. I appreciate it very, very, very much. And I also, and our executive director as well, Santiago Wood, and all of the members of the board, my most sincere appreciation to everyone. Thank you, and a very special thanks, first of all, here to my husband for his love and support. And one of my sons, one of my four children, is here. Also, Dr. Tinajero, please stand, and thank you for all your love and support. All my four children are educators, all four of them. Special thank you to all of you who are here. This award is extremely special to me because it comes from the government of Mexico, and that's my native land, my native country. And as many of you know, I was born in the beautiful city of Chihuahua and came to the U.S. with my parents at the age of 5, not knowing a single word of English. And I was a non-English speaker. At the time when children were punished in schools for speaking their home language. And that very painful experience left an indelible mark that has shaped my entire professional career and my professional life. You know, I was a pretty stubborn child. Because of that experience, I became even more determined to do well in school and to do something so that no child would have to experience the kinds of things that I experienced. It also inspired me to become involved in producing the very best instructional materials in English and in Spanish we possibly could have for our children. Books in Spanish that I was dying to have when I was in the classroom. Materials that would whet the literacy and imaginative appetites of our children that reflected their language and their culture, and that often is disregarded in mainstream texts. Books written in Spanish beginning the mid-80s with Mil Maravillas, Campanitas de Oro, Lectura en Español, Tesoros, and books for children also to learn the academic English, Into English, High Point, Avenues, Treasures, Wanderers, In the USA, published by McGraw-Hill, Hampton Brown, National Geographic. And I thank also those companies for having me be part of their authorship. Unfortunately, you know, not all children of my generation can tell a story with a happy ending that mine has had. For me, the turning point didn't come until the 7th grade, and the literature and the research is right on target. It was at that time that I felt that I knew enough English to feel comfortable to do the academic tasks. It was not until then that I could express in English what my heart thought and my mind thought in Spanish. And it was only then that I felt that I could belong and succeed. And that year, I did belong. I was inducted into the Junior Honor Society, and later, when I graduated from high school, as class valedictorian. So 7 years it took me to becoming English, but I already was in Spanish. And in part, I owe that ultimate success to the rich learning environment in Spanish that my parents sought to construct for their children. You see, my father, who was college educated in Mexico, was a LEP adult in Texas, and so Spanish was the only language that we spoke at home. And my dad would say, aquí en esta casa se habla español, y solamente español. were in essence my bilingual teachers, and they created for me and for all their 9 children a world of literature, of cuentos, of art, de los colores, el sarape, verde, rojo, naranjado, amarillo, azul, a world of geography and music, la negra, carabe, Jalisco, and poetry. They created for me a world that was diffused in culture and color and vibrancy and pride. Orgullo, mi papá tenía tanto orgullo por su México. Por esta música, por todo lo de nuestros antepasados, un orgullo que nos dio a todos sus 9 hijos. But this fully formed, life-filled, to ever-flowing world became for me in English a formless void. But I'll always be a proponent of bilingual education. I lived the experience, I felt the anxiety, and like many of you, I heard the calling. And because of my own personal painful experience and history and struggles in school, the education of IELTS has become my mission, it has become my passion. And educators like all of you, educators of IELTS, are my heroes. You are my heroes. You are my heroes, you are my voice, and it is among you that I feel the most at home, the most fulfilled, and the most understood. You remind me of the voices that I heard as my mother carried me in her womb. You remind me of my wonderful childhood years at home, in my neighborhood, and in the games that we used to play in our neighborhood. Las quemadas y las escondidas, and leche, las cebollitas y las pistones. ¿Se acuerdan ustedes? Uno de ustedes, ¿no? You represent the language that I longed to hear at school and my teachers uttered before I could make sense of the English language. As a child, one of the things that also left a permanent mark in my life was the pláticas from mi papá, el señor Reveriano Alfonso Villamil, who had a great respect and admiration and love for the literature, the music, the language, the history, and the richness of my beautiful native country, Mexico. Recuerdo en particular un poema de Amado Nervo, que siempre lo recitaba, era de Amado Nervo, Raza de Bronce, y empezaba con, oh, mi bonita raza, y se arrancaba como por media hora. And he would continue to elaborate about esas grandes y majestuosas civilizaciones de nuestros pasados, y nos platicaba de los mayas y chichimecas y los aztecas, speakers of the Nahuatl language, after which this award is named. En Otli, which means path or journey. Desde muy chica me hice una firme promesa, no dejar que mis hermanos de raza pasaran por las mismas experiencias negativas escolares que yo pasé. No, nunca. Como dice Gustavo Adolfo Bécquer en su rima 41, la senda estrecha, inevitable choque. No puede ser, no puede ser. Tengo mi promesa firme, abrir los caminos de las oportunidades universitarias desde la educación primaria para nuestra gente. Abrir estos caminos tan anchos como las antiguas calzadas de nuestro gran Tenochtitlán, en donde todas las ideas y esperanzas de mi gente mexicana latina pueden caminar por ellas sin temer sus anhelos, cualquiera que ese fuera en el cualicote, en una jornada feliz con la lengua nueva. Por eso, hermanos, hemos trabajado incansablemente para promover la equidad de nuestra gente en los Estados Unidos. Papá les hubiera estado muy contento, ya no está con nosotros, pero hubiera estado muy orgulloso por haber dedicado gran parte de mi vida profesional a procurar la prosperidad de las comunidades mexicanas aquí en los Estados Unidos y abrir vías para mejorar la calidad de la vida de la población migrante. Y con esto les deseo a todos, en verdad, I wish everyone a ma holy holy en sus vidas.